Hi, I'm Jessica from Rise Above Lyme Support Group. Today I want to share information about a Lyme disease Herx and discuss a Lyme disease flare. Let's dig into this subject. Now I want to start with Dr. Richard Horowitz's book, How Can I Get Better? In it, he describes the Herxheimer reaction as a temporary worsening of the symptoms of Lyme disease that occurs when the Lyme spirochete is killed off by antibiotics, creating inflammation. He adds that these Herx reactions produce cytokines, which then create inflammatory symptoms, including increased fever, muscle and joint pain, headaches, cognitive impairment, and a general worsening of the underlying symptomology. Telling the difference between a Herx and a flare is a good thing to learn so that you can help yourself take control of it and do things that might help. The goal is to keep moving forward in your healing. You can still heal even if you can't tell the difference, so don't worry about that, about being like an expert in it. We aren't meant to be tortured, and a bad Herx can be dangerous, so we must listen to our bodies. Now, when this happens, fear would take over. My random thoughts would get the best of me. I would worry about a few things. I would think, am I backtracking? Am I getting worse? Should I stop treating? Am I gonna die? Is this dangerous? I would ask myself a million things. Not knowing what steps to take is extremely stressful for a Lyme patient because we want to get better so badly that many of us tend to push the limits of suffering. The saying in the community about taking things low and slow, or it's a marathon, not a race, holds great merit for solid reasons. So let's focus on a Herx for now. As I mentioned earlier, a Herxheimer reaction is bacteria breaking down in the body. Most of us call it die-off. Let's say you're taking antibiotics or an herbal antibiotic in your treatment. This Herx reaction may not happen immediately. It could be 3 days later even. The bacteria are killed off. This literally floods your body with the toxins from the die-off of the bacteria. This makes you feel horrible, like you've been poisoned. I screamed from shock when I first felt it. My poor parents witnessed it. There is no easy way to even explain how bad it feels. So you kind of are poisoned in a way. Basically, your body has an immune response, creates inflammation in the body, and it just really makes you feel terrible. This process makes all of the problems we have and the symptoms stronger, and even new ones can appear. Joint pain, headaches, fatigue, all of it can feel plain worse. When you Herx, you produce cytokines. Cytokines cause inflammatory symptoms, making a general worsening of any symptom you're used to experiencing. You feel toxic. So the sooner you clear these toxins, the sooner you will feel better. This is why we focus so much on detox in this disease. You simply cannot treat without this vital piece. To promote healing, the inflammatory cytokines and the dying bacteria need to be cleared from the body. We help the body do this with good detox methods. Please watch my detox video for more on this. So, again, when the body can't clear these toxins from the bloodstream fast enough, it results in an acid imbalance that impairs the enzymes needed to maintain a normal pH, which is balance of acidity to alkalinity in the body. The more spirochetes that die, the stronger the reaction will be. So the faster people can clear dead bacteria from their bodies, the sooner you will feel better. This disease is not like taking something for other conditions like bronchitis or a skin infection, when in 24 to 48 hours, we get the luxury of feeling better. This is the horrible truth about treating. It feels very unfair. And you know, it is. So a Herx is usually related to adding a new therapy of some sort. The most common advice in this situation, if it gets too intense, is usually to just back off and work on detox, increase your anti-inflammatory choices in your protocol. Listen to your body and let it recover and calm down. Torture is never okay and never the goal. You are meant to tolerate this. I had to take many breaks in my personal treatment, and when I restarted, I would often tolerate it much better. I pushed the limit a few times and I regret doing that. Breaks are okay and we still move forward with them. The main difference between a Herx reaction and a flare usually comes down to what caused it. With a Herx, it can be caused by increasing a treatment protocol, a full moon, even eating something antimicrobial in nature can do it. Now, this can happen without that if you didn't detox fully last round in it and you have stores in your body's fat cells. I consider it like waking up the leftovers. You can, and sometimes waking them up is just by using a biomat or a sauna or other ways that heated the body, even exercise can do it. So a Herx and a flare both cause inflammation. So it's part of why it's so hard to know what the heck is happening. But remember, it's okay not to know. Sometimes the solution for both is just taking a break. Add stuff back in slowly to help identify the real culprit. Plus, this lets our bodies calm down. Herxes tend to be all over your body, including neuro stuff. But a patient must at least consider drug reactions, even from herbals. This doesn't necessarily mean you're allergic, but if the reaction seems to match the drug warnings, it may be that. Now, these reactions will usually resolve shortly after the medication is stopped. If it's a severe allergic reaction called anaphylaxis, it can cause swelling of the airways, etc., and you'll need immediate help. These instances are way more rare. Now, most Lyme-trained doctors educate us on how to tell the difference between a good Herx and a bad Herx. A good Herx is when, as each one passes over time, you start feeling better as your bacterial load lessens. Basically, your overall symptoms are improving. I can't even explain the relief when my head pressure and back pain finally went away. It was hard to imagine it ever would, but it did. A bad Herx can be dangerous, and in very rare instances, fatal. So feeling bad is okay, but feeling really bad warrants being seen, even if it's the dreaded ER. ERs are infamous for not taking us seriously. Watch my dismissive doctor's video to learn more on that. Your doctor can help you determine what is going on and suggest what to do to help. Now, flares are more simple to explain, at least for me. Herxing feels kind of like all over, but a flare-up can have many different causes, making a person's symptoms worse. Could be food sensitivities, mold exposure, a deficiency in your diet, or the natural progress of the disease. It can feel like Herxing, and that's okay. I flare when I don't get enough sleep, something stressful happens to me, I cheat on gluten or dairy, I exercise too hard. All those affect the immune system. I can recover pretty quickly with enough self-care. To make all this simple, a Herx is usually from adding something for the most part. 48 to 72 hours later is usually when it hits. 3 days for me most of the time. People with chronic Lyme suffer consistent and often debilitating bizarre symptoms. We have to be our own detective. Keeping in touch with your Lyme treating physician can certainly help increase your chances of identifying what is causing your symptoms so you act accordingly. I know it's easy to feel overwhelmed as this disease is complicated and the treatment is no different. This is what all Lyme patients feel, so take heart, you aren't alone, I promise. The best advice is to listen to your body and trust your instincts. This comes with time. I know it seems sad, but you need to know your normal level of suffering, your baseline. With that, you'll start to recognize new fluctuations, how frequently they happen, how strong those symptoms get. Recording these things on a calendar helped me track and learn, because otherwise I felt like I was just a mess all the time. I can say this, I used to have all bad days. Eventually, I had some good days, but the bad days always outweighed them. Even to the point, I sometimes couldn't even remember my last good day. But with time, my good days started winning the contest. Bad days hit when they chose, and I do what I can to prevent them, but it's often out of my hands. And I have learned to respect the process and embrace how far I've come. I plan to do a video on my journey soon, so if you want to see how very far I've come, please watch it, as it may provide you some real hope. I will list Herx remedies below in the description box. Please like my video, and most importantly, please hit subscribe so that you'll see my next video. Thanks for listening, and I hope somehow I helped you.